Alright, this is the Big Tasty. Welcome back. Hey, I'm B. Here are my friend.
Luda.
What? So we're gonna start doing this once a week because I feel like I miss you guys.
I feel like it's just something that we need to do on a weekly basis.
Yeah, because I wanted to talk about a gang of stuff, but like it all passed already.
Yeah.
So we can't talk about it now because it's too long.
But I feel like 2 weeks is like way far away now.
Maybe we could start doing it like video because I don't want to see you every week. No, just kidding.
Do like a conference meeting.
Yeah.
So, all right. Well, we got week two here.
Week two. We got a special guest today.
I feel like I have to ask permission to talk. Like,
you am do. I supposed no, to be wait, known? Why are you talking? I know. You haven't asked.
I know. We don't.
When I point at
no
you,
no one even knows
talk.
Who you are right now. When we point, you go.
I'm a mystery.
So we have a special guest today. Just kidding. Started all over. We're gonna edit all that out.
Take no, two.
So, yeah, right. Well, he basically introduced himself already. Danny Medina.
Hello. Pleasure to be here.
Danny Medina.
Pleasure to be here in this world class studio.
Yes, very.
What are you selling?
What am I selling? <That's kidding. laughs> You know, every time I come to a studio like this, I always like to bring my loafers.
He's not wearing loafers.
No.
Anyway. They're weird looking though.
Yeah, my shoes are all beat up now. You guys can't see them, but my shoes are pretty torn up. These are my I call them my rain dress shoes.
Rain?
So I have my nice dress shoes that I don't want to get dirty. So if it's raining, I'll put these ones on because they already look terrible and I don't have to worry about ruining them.
It's not raining.
Rain dress shoes.
But it's not raining.
Pick them up today at your local Thrifties.
Do you like them?
Thrifties is ice cream.
I got them at Ross.
So, hey, man, well, I'm glad you were able to join us today.
Yeah. I am totally here by accident. Everybody knows.
That
is clear.
True. But we're going to make it work.
Make it work.
I mean, I think this is a good way for you, for your name to get out there and for our name to get out there.
So, there you go.
Yeah, why not?
Sounds like me every time I go to the bathroom.
Yeah. Let's not start with that. No, I'm just kidding.
So
he's Danny's an artist, a musician.
Yeah, tell us about yourself, Danny. Yeah.
So
for people that don't know you.
For people that, okay, so
your daytime job and nighttime job.
Oh, okay. So I do techno. No, I mean, if we want to get the real in-depth Danny, the real nitty-gritty Danny, I guess we could talk about my collection of shoes. No, I'm just kidding. By day, I work
feel like
for
you were.
By day, I work for Los Angeles Times. Nice. That is a newspaper. And for those of you who are younger, a newspaper is a paper that you hold in your hands that you can't touch screen, and it's actually you have to read
actually,
it.
Actually, you could see it on your tablet, so.
Yeah, okay.
Well, you could touch screen. Right.
And by night, I talk on podcasts and try not to ruin them.
Cool. Now, I got first question. Mm-hmm. Is this your first podcast?
Is this my first recorded podcast? Yeah. Yes. Have I been recorded before without my knowledge? Probably.
So like you've done
I might
fake
have stumbled into
I know.
Some studio.
He's like, I do a podcast every time I'm in the shower. Instead of singing.
I don't know how it happens. But
we want to welcome Mr. Bubbles today.
He's like, I don't have a problem singing in public, so I do podcasts in the shower.
Second question. What's your position at the Register or the LA Times?
Surviving.
Other newspapers.
No, my position is I work so pretty much inside sales. I do classified, so marketplace. If somebody dies, they call us. We do an obituary for them.
Cool. Is okay. Cool. The $100 billion question.
$100 billion.
I forgot.
Wow.
No wonder you're broke.
Wow.
No wonder.
Back down to zero.
No. I think it was how is business booming?
Is business booming? So that's a good question. In the newspaper industry that I know nothing about, I guess you could say as long as you're a newspaper and you're still selling newspapers, you're doing pretty well. I mean, obviously, the world is all about
media.
iPads, and it's a digital world we live in now. Yeah. So, you know, it's something to be said about something like the Los Angeles Times. It's still around, and that's a best case scenario is hopefully it'll be around for a while. They're still printing paper.
Yeah,
I went in there, and the printing press looks pretty crazy. It's like it's weird because there's so much history in there, but at the same time, it's like
is it old stuff like. I always picture like printing press. I'm like thinking like it's old school, like you see in those black and white movies.
Yeah, big old machines.
Is it like that?
You'd be surprised. They bring in these big old rolls of paper and they're huge. They weigh tons. And there's literally robots in the room that grabs these papers and loads them onto these big machines that runs the paper.
Dude, they're Mexicans. They're not called robots.
Exactly. So,
they're not called robots.
So right now, like, I want to make sure we put out the case to get rights for these robots that are working free labor.
Everyone needs rights.
Yeah.
But that's cool. But yeah, no, I'd say business is booming. I think that people still value the newspaper, you know, and slowly but surely.
Yeah, because there's all those people like that retired already that got nothing to do.
Yeah, exactly.
They want to read every single thing. Or hipsters. They don't read it, though. I think they just sit there and pretend to read it with their man buns.
Exactly.
I don't know.
I have no idea what these words are.
They're in a coffee shop.
Their phone's in the paper, just right there.
They're reading it upside down.
Just looking at the pictures.
Excuse me, sir. Why are you staring at me? I'm just trying to read the paper in my rain shoes.
In my rain shoes.
All right. Well, that's cool. Well, like I said, again, I'm glad you're able to join us.
Yeah.
And like, surprisingly, you're just like, surprise, you're joining us for a podcast.
Okay. Well, hey, I know you have more questions, but my turn.
All right.
Okay.
My turn. This is the real stuff. We're
we have a secret relationship. We haven't came out to the fans yet.
Dude. So my question is, and it's for both of you. You got to both answer one at a time, or you can answer all together. What inspired you guys to do this podcast?
I'll let you.
Me?
Yeah.
Well, because I love podcasts. I listen to so many podcasts, and I could drop so many podcast names that I listen to, but it'd be too long. I listen to. All
so
the
four?
Time. Yeah. So, yeah. Yeah. Because I can't really read too well. So it takes me a long time to read it. No. No, but I just like podcasts. I like talking. Me and Chris have like a good rapport where we just talk. We could just talk about anything. So, and then Chris came up to me because I had mentioned it before. Like, I wanted to record some podcasts. I wanted to do something. And Chris came into some recording stuff and he was like, hey, I want to see if you want to do it. And I was like, yeah, I jumped at it.
Nice.
So. That's why I do it, and I want to connect with people and just be able to talk. I like to talk.
Sweet, man.
So,
yeah, I mean, I agree.
Luda?
Like, he does like to talk. No, but I think
just
that's a
heckled
great thing.
You on your own podcast.
I know that's all right because I didn't let him talk the first one, so no. I talked the whole other one.
No, but I when I was listening to the first podcast, I was like, damn, Brian, I feel like you could be. Like, and I say you could be because I know you have the great potential to do it. So you could be a great host.
Oh, thank you, man. Yeah. I thought that too when I listened. No, I'm just kidding.
You guys don't see this, but they stared intensely into each other's eyes right now while caressing each other's hands, just encouraging one another.
We should have him here every time just to tell everybody what we're doing.
Right? The play-by-play.
Yeah. Why are you playing footsies?
He slowly removed his hat.
For me... why or interested me to start this podcast? I'm honestly fairly new to listening to podcasts. I think I've tried different podcasts, but some of them hasn't really got my attention yet. One that really has got my attention was Worship Leader Props. Follow them; they're dope.
Nice.
They're
plug.
Just a
quick plug.
Quick plug.
Quick plug.
A shameless plug.
Right.
But yeah, I listen to them a lot, and I just because I can relate to them very easily, and I think that's what connects to you with the podcast is when you could relate to it, or if it makes you laugh, and just you know something you like.
Yeah.
And there's so many out there, it's hard to find one.
Yeah.
So.
Well, once you find one that suits your like personality and stuff that you like. Then you like you never want to stop listening to it. You're like waiting for the next episode.
Agreed.
You know, because like me, when I was growing up, I wanted to be a comedian growing up. I used to have like all the comedy videos. I had like all the DVDs because that's back then it was like all DVDs. So I had like stacks and stacks of DVDs. I had like 50 of them. And then like I had my own set that I would do for my family at parties and stuff. And like right now, the big thing, comedians, like I still follow a lot of comedians. Mm. And everyone's doing podcasts because that's how they're getting their comedy out there and their style out there and what they're doing.
That's true.
Right? So I listen to them just because I follow them. And then like, to me, they're funny. And then they just say some interesting stuff. So I was like, man, that'd be pretty cool to be like that. So podcast is one thing, sort of like my childhood dream almost. Because I'm not a comedian, but like I could do some stuff like comedians do.
One might say your dream came true.
What?
You know, it's crazy because if you really think about it, podcasts are the one, because the world is full of social media. It's full of just people posting like, hey, this is the burger I ate today, or hey, this is the Starbucks drink I had today.
Yeah.
But,
yeah,
you know, people are starving for connection. Yeah. And I feel like for me, I listen to a few podcasts myself. I won't plug any because, you know, I'm that guy. But, you know, for me, I know the reason I listen to the podcast that I listen to is because I do feel a sense of connection. I feel like, you know what, these guys are talking about things. I thought these were celebrities. I thought these were people that, like, they had their own lives. They're driving around in Maseratis and wearing sunglasses. No, these guys are driving around in minivans and going to Starbucks and waiting in the same line I have to wait in. And it's just so crazy to see that, you know what, I can connect with that. This guy's talking about things that I'm worried about in my life, things that I like in my life. And it's just, it's such an alternate reality to be able to see that these are real people. Everybody who does these podcasts are real people. And all they do is connect with you. Yeah. Hey, this is how we're feeling today. Hey, let's talk about this.
Yeah.
And I think that's our big goal too, is just connect. Even if we don't connect with a whole bunch of people, one person, like I talk a lot about, like, the last podcast, I talked about my kids a lot and like the connection, like I wish we had a stronger connection is how I'm doing that. And maybe somebody out there hears that and they're like, well, I'm not the only one. I could relate to what he's saying. You know, so that's the biggest thing. And another thing is too, like, I don't like watching the news. I hate watching the news. Right, because it's so negative. Everything that comes out the news, and then they'll tell you the story, and then that's it. Like, it's just plain, you know. There's just facts. That's it. And with podcasts, they still give you like current events. They still tell you what's happening, or if they've seen something on the news, right? They'll tell you about it, but they'll do it with like a little bit of comedy, or like, and then they'll be like, "Oh man!" Like, you could hear the emotion. It's not so dry, you know. And I like hearing my current events like that.
Obviously, I like relating to the podcast to be able to be like, oh man, I'm not the only one who thinks like that way, or I'm not the only one who is struggling this way, or even just like certain stuff like, oh man, that was hilarious, like, you know. And I just want to spread the word to other people about what I'm going through, or what I'm noticing.
Well, I applaud you guys, you know, because it's incredibly brave to be that vulnerable. You know, funny thing is, you asked me, talk about yourself, you know, I was gonna sit here and be like, yeah, I have a 401k and my
anyway. Stop bragging, bro. I'm just kidding. Going to.
So, but honestly, you know, if I'm gonna sit here and be real with you guys, because this is one of those podcasts.
Yeah.
You know, I just celebrated my 33rd birthday.
Yeah. What?
Thank you. I'm an old man. I know. Yeah, when you said you used to listen to DVDs or watch DVDs, listen. There you go. That's my age right there.
Yeah.
The first thing I thought was like
I had 8-tracks.
I used to watch VHS. And use the little race car rewinder.
We had that too. I had that too. Yeah. But DVD was like more recent, like high school.
Yeah. I'm older. Anywho. Yeah. But you know, honestly, if you
wait, but then sorry, I kind of cut you off, but Brian's not that much younger than you.
I'm 31. He's not, you swear.
You're 31?
Yeah.
I'm the dirty one.
31. It's the first time I heard that.
I'm the dirty one.
Oh man. But anywho.
Yeah, you're 33.
To expand on that, like, if I'm going to really tell you how I, honestly, dude, at the first point in my life, and it's so funny to think of it like this, but for the first time in my life, I actually feel older. I actually feel like, you know what, this year, I actually feel like,
you feel 33?
I feel 33. And before this, like, even when I turned 30, I was like, I don't feel old. I feel like that age for me is going to be 40. It's like, whoa, I hit the hill. I'm almost over it. What have I done? You know?
Well, with me, you know what it is? Like, I always feel like when I'm around people my age, I'm always like, dang, they're like old, you know, and I feel younger than them. And I'm like, I feel like I don't look that old. I don't act like them, you know, but then again, they're probably thinking the same thing about me. They're like, this dude got a big old beard. Does he, you know, you know what I mean? All these gray hairs.
401ks.
Yeah. You know what I mean? So it's like, I feel you on that one. You don't feel 30. I don't feel 31. I feel like 28 or 27. Like, I feel like a little younger, not maybe like a whole bunch, but
at least a couple of years.
Hell yeah, man. I mean, that's to be honest, I'd rather feel that way, but you know, it was a bittersweet good like moment for me, because I think I'm ready to feel older. I'm ready to finally say, you know what, I feel a little older this year.
Can you start acting a little older, please?
You know, I will. Let me put down my pogs and my rollerblades here.
Do you know what pogs are?
Yeah, I never play with them.
He's like, I still got a slammer.
No.
Like, still got
I never played it. I never played it, but I know
Pokemon,
what it is.
You're Pokemon, huh?
Chris is the baby right here.
Or Yu-Gi-Oh.
You're the baby.
I'm the baby.
Do they know you as Chris or just Luda?
Now they know me as Chris.
Well, now they know you now as they Chris. Know.
It's all good. Hey, I mean,
he'll edit it out.
Beep. Beep. Bleep, bleep. Nah, but I mean, if anybody wanted to find out, they're going to find out. So it's all good. Plus, if you really look on the Spotify, it says like, who it's created by? It says Chris. So, whatever.
Just say your middle name too and your birthday.
I know, everyone just look me up.
Social security number.
Yeah. But, all right, well, let's get started to the next one. And before we get to talking about, you know, different topics, want to plug in a sponsored by At Solution Meals.
Ooh.
Yes, you need your meal preps for the week.
Wait a minute. Am I listening to the first ad break right
this
now?
This is the first ad break.
This is the first so ad
this
break?
This is our first sponsor,
this
man.
Is like, this is first like live.
Milestone.
No written.
That is uncanny.
No written lyric. No written like line for like.
Wow. Hey. So what is this? What is this sponsor?
So how much are they paying you?
No, I
want a meal, bro. Oh, you already gave me one.
Yeah, I already gave one.
I guess I got it already. Hey, man, I didn't even know.
No, I really, what's the word? I'm really inspired. I'm really motivated by this guy who is just creating his own business and just starting this thing. He's a dietitian. Like, he went to school for it, and he just really wants to.
And what are these meals like? What are special about these meals?
What's special about?
Yeah, let the listeners know.
No, so I mean, he has different plans where you could make it, but all kinds of different meats.
Like
so,
keto? Do keto?
So you could do keto, low carb. You could just do. He goes off the base points, which is your protein, your carbs, and I don't know what you do for vegetables. Kind of because some vegetables are for like carbs and whatever, but you choose different stuff.
So these are like geared towards helping you like acquire like losing weight or building muscle or things like that.
Yeah. Oh, and, okay. And he's always willing to help
you
out. So
what are yours geared to? What type of meals you?
Yeah. What's your drive?
What's my drive? So at first my first 2 weeks were just regular like healthy eating meals was just, it was protein. Like I would do like, say for instance, chicken, potatoes and like broccoli.
Tapatoes.
Does that make you fart?
No, actually, yeah, it didn't.
Gassy. Broccoli.
That's a good question.
Broccoli makes me gassy.
Do greens make you gassy?
But see, that's the thing. I don't like all the broccoli. I don't eat all of it.
But then you're really not doing his job if you don't eat the whole meal. Stick to the plan, bro.
Thanks, Brian.
He does great plans that I don't follow.
No, it's just because
you're getting lazy, man.
No, I'll be honest with you. Like, I'm not a big vegetable eater. So, for me to eat,
because you're five.
Wow,
I'm not a big vegetable eater. I just want chips.
I just want potatoes.
But I can't lose weight.
A bunch of potatoes.
I can't lose weight.
The cheese, Brian.
Wait, what's the name of this business again?
So, At Solution Meals. You can find them on Instagram. You could order the meals straight through Instagram. And like I said, you choose your protein. You could choose your sides and your vegetables.
And they are delicious. I tried one. He gave it to me, and I ate it. And I was like, this is bomb. And I didn't even heat it up.
Yeah, he
was
in a hurry. Really?
I ate it cold. It was like chicken and stuff, right? And potatoes. And I ate it, and I was like, dude, this is bomb. I should have heated this up.
Yeah. Dude, it's so good. And like, he puts the sauce and like different stuff with it. So like this week, I got pork loin with broccoli and bell pepper mix.
Dang.
So good. And he gives me a salsa, like a little salsa, like, and it's fresh. He makes it fresh, and I put it on top, dude.
I was thinking it was like a kid cuisine.
We
like
should have invited him.
Comes with a little microwave burner.
Well, no,
that would have been a good first guess. See, man, that would have been way better first guess.
Be like, oh, you know, oh, here's our new sponsor, and to be honest, is actually our sponsor here. Yeah. Sorry.
What can we have for free?
He had prior engagements.
Sponsoring you with joy.
No, I was just kidding.
No, but
this one's all right.
No, but he
we'll take this one.
He said he's down to be on the podcast.
Awesome.
So he won't stop touching me though.
So we'll have him on here.
It's the reason we don't film it.
But yeah, Solution Meals. Follow him on Instagram.
If you plug the Big Tasty, he'll give you a free high five.
We're actually in the works.
What?
In the works.
Nice.
That I want to. I'm in the talk with him about like
code.
When we give him our viewers or listeners, we'll give him a code, and then we'll get a discount, or they'll get a discount. So it's in the works.
Big Tasty.
And how fitting that the name of your podcast is the Big Tasty.
Big Tasty food.
Yeah, right.
Better not suck.
So But it's hard to do the code thing because he's, you know, fairly started new. So like he doesn't, you don't have anywhere to put the code in unless type it in the DM. But
dropping his DMs.
Dropping his DMs.
That's so nice. Again, I want to drop Swoosh and Meals. And yeah, so let's go ahead and get started with the next topic.
Cool. Well, I wanted to bring something
Chris
up.
Wants to move on. Yeah, you called him five.
What the heck?
I'm trying to shoring up this podcast, make sure we're going on time here.
All right, I know. Hey, you know what's been bothering me lately?
What's
drive-thrus, man.
Drive-thrus?
I hate repeating myself at drive-thrus. And lately, I feel like I have to repeat. Because I'm like,
I'm so with the kick go.
Because you get ready, right? You get up to the drive-thru and you're like, what do you want, guys? What do you want? Hold on a second. I'm not ready. You tell them, right?
Yeah.
And then they're like, okay, whenever you're ready. Cool, got you.
Yeah.
You get everyone's order, right? And then you're like, okay, I'm ready. And they're like, I'm ready too. You tell them the long order and they're like, okay, did you say? I just told you. You said you was ready. Like, what? And I'm not just being a jerk, right? Because I've worked fast food for a long time.
Yeah.
And I got to know what it is. Like, dude, just listen. Just pay attention to me. Yeah. I hate repeating myself. Yeah. No, I hate ordering to begin with.
I hear you.
But
what are you going to say?
I feel like I deal with that every time I go to the drive-thru. And lately, I haven't been going to the drive-thru just because of I've been doing like healthy eating. But when I do,
you just
like,
drive through it.
Just drive through it. I remember I used to come here every day. Yeah. But yeah, no man, like you exactly what you said. You'd like you go up there and be like, oh, can I help you? And I was like, oh, just give me a second. I'm still deciding or whatever. And then they're like, yeah, let me know when you're ready. So I find out what I want. I find out what everyone else wants in the car. And I'm like, all right, hello. And they're like, yeah, I'm ready. Or can I take your order? And then you tell them everything, and then they're like, oh, so you wanted extra pickles? I'm like, no, I want no pickles.
Yeah, right? The complete opposite.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, you wanted a McFlurry? No, I wanted steak, you know?
You want your shake in the burger? Okay, we could do that.
You know what I do? I snap at them, too, sometimes, right? Because, like, on accident, too, and you can't be doing that at drive-thru, man, because you can't be getting on their bad side, right? But, right, like, we'll pull up.
He's speaking from experience.
We'll pull up, and I'll be like, yeah, right? And I'll be like, just a second, please. And they'll be like, yeah, can I help you? Yeah, just a second, please. Yeah, go ahead and order. I said just a second, like, please.
Right? Try to be polite.
Whoever's in the car with me is always like, dude, don't wanna like, don't be yelling at them.
I don't want to hear now.
And then when I am ready, I'm like, I'm ready. Like, oh man,
yo,
for real, man.
Hey.
Yeah, dude. Like they're talking about earthquakes and everything right now on the news and like. You know, all these epidemics that are going around, but we really got to face the major issues.
Yeah, that's what we're worried about.
And it's the failing sound systems at every drive-thru you go. Have you ever gone up to a Jack in the Box drive-thru and it's just.
Yeah.
You want to try the number 5 today? Dude. It's every time, dude. Every time.
That happened to me last week. I went to talk about, I was going to get like the Power Katina Bowls. Like, it was a healthy choice.
At a drive-thru.
And then he's like, and I'm like,
hey, who's our sponsor again?
Is it my turn to talk?
Who's our sponsor again?
The sponsor?
Yeah.
At Solution Meals.
At Solution Meals, are you listening to this?
Yeah, exactly.
He's
exactly.
Not following the plan. He's broke, in drive-thrus.
He broke the plan.
I forgot my meal at home.
Like that's, I said, that's a great not excuse. Following the plan. Dang,
that was on.
I still ate it for dinner.
On the fly.
I ate it for dinner.
You ate extra. You're still not following the plan. Come on, we're keeping you on your toes here, man. I want you to lose some weight,
fine.
Bro.
I'm
worried about your health.
I'm not feeling guilty at all.
That old ticker can't last two. No, I'm kidding.
But yeah, that happened to me last week. I was like, they tried, and then they repeat the order to you, and you're like, yeah, sure.
Hey, when
what sucks is when they don't have it on the screen.
I guess that's what I'm getting.
Or how about they read back the whole thing and it's not on the screen yet? Exactly. And then as you're driving away, it pops up. Exactly. You're like, wait.
That's not what I said. Yeah. That's the real problem here right now.
Yeah, the real problems in the nation today.
One time I cussed a person out when I was working the drive-thru.
Oh, really?
Right? But it was an accident because like on the box that they give you that's around your waist, it has A and B, right? So like you push button A, you could talk to the customer and everybody could hear you, right? You push B, only the employees could hear you, right? So this lady was giving me a hard time and I was like talking to her. And then like I went to go press B and I was like, this bitch. Like, right? Oh, and then she's like, excuse me? And I was, it's pulling around the window, please. I was 17, so I was like, oh, it's pulling around the window, please.
Did you hide and have like one of your other coworkers?
I was like, she got to the window and I was like, I sent him home. This is ridiculous.
We took care of the situation.
I changed my voice. I'm like, I sent him home. That was ridiculous.
Dude, you played that off smooth. That was
quick.
Well, he was eating fries and everything. Look.
Look at him. Look at him. He got ridiculous. Some on my beard. Look
yeah. Ridiculous. I couldn't grow a beard back then, man. I was only 17. Come on, man. Remind me of those times. Yeah,
I'm 33. I still can't grow a beard. All right? Dude.
That is his beard.
I can barely do a mustache. I'm freaking 20. What am I? 29.
I forgot my age. I'm 20.
Yeah, for real. Hey, you know, quick fact.
That unhealthy eating is probably messing with your memory, bro.
The what?
The unhealthy eating.
Oh, the healthy eating. Wow.
The unhealthy eating.
I know.
The unhealthy. You better stick to your @solutionmeals.com.
Yeah, man. We pushed in our first sponsor so hard. Right.
Hey, it's getting out there.
I think
there.
You're supposed to plug it for like 2 seconds. We're plugging it the whole podcast.
We're so excited to have a sponsor.
Yeah, anyways.
Did you hear about Elon Musk?
What?
He claims to have tested and like it works, chips that he puts in your brain so you could use your computer with your thoughts instead of using a mouse.
He tested it?
Yeah, and it works.
How do you put chips like in your brain?
Like he puts it in your brain, bro. Like injects it in there.
What?
Or something. I don't know. I'm not a freaking scientist. I'm just saying he could put them in there and it works.
He's like, I just read it on my phone right now. I didn't get all the facts yet.
It was on the news. Well, not on the news.
I thought you don't watch the news.
It was my version of the news. That's what I was like, it's not the news. But it was my version of the news.
His version of the news. Hey, going to my phone while I'm taking a dump.
So, this is bro science.
This is bro science.
Dang, so chips in the brain.
Yeah.
And you control it with your brain, your thoughts.
Yeah. Like, what do you think of that?
Question. Okay. Let's say you're sitting there. And you're sitting at a Starbucks and you got that chip in your brain, right? We all know your mind likes to travel. Your mind likes to go places and you got to look up, I don't know, who Elon Musk is.
Yeah, right?
But let's say out of nowhere, you have a thought of maybe another website and that website pops
Pornhub?
Up. How do you get rid of that website if it's connected to your brain?
Well, if it's connected to your brain and you react to it, I'm sure when you react, you're going to be like, oh, man, I can't be on this. Get out.
Yeah, but what and if you go out right? and just keep thinking of those things, and all of a sudden you got 35 websites up, and you can't get rid of any of them.
That's when you slam the laptop.
Your computer's moaning and screaming at people around it.
Just shut up!
I said 1 second.
You're all close.
What kind of drink was that, sir? Nothing.
Right?
Where's the mouse? Oh, crying.
Control-Alt-Delete.
Right? Hey, but what if Elon Musk doesn't tell us, like, the whole story, and he could control us through the computer? Because it's a chip in our brain. Or he's hearing all our thoughts.
Either or.
I just heard the X-Files theme song come on right now.
I don't know it.
How's it going?
Do it louder.
Oh, yeah, there it is.
I was like, I don't think that's it, but then you went longer, and I was like, no, that's it.
Weirdo. Yeah, I nailed that, didn't I?
That was pretty good. Yeah. That was pretty good. I just heard a recent story of Elon Musk, him going, when those India kids were stuck in the... What?
Were they India kids? Threw it out. India kids. You know the world's full of Mexicans, white people, and India kids.
They're from India.
So they're Indians?
No. I didn't say that.
I don't know.
Children.
Children. No, but they were from a different country and they were stuck in a different country.
Was it India or was it?
There was a soccer team.
Where were they stuck?
Cambodia or India?
I think it was India.
Oh, the same thing?
But where were they stuck? In a hole?
We paid attention.
They were stuck in a cave. Anyways, I just remember Elon Musk. I found out just recently that he like...
Oh, this is a while back, right?
Yeah. He like created this big old submarine that he like created it, built it, sent it over there. Then they went under the cave and like, well, he told them like, hey, I have this. I can save the children. Like, I could do this. And they're like, no, we don't want your help. And so then they, but instead of him like leaving and be like, all right, screw you guys. He ended up saying, he was like, okay, what can I do then? And he was like there. They said like he got on his knees. Like he was like pulling dirt. He was like just hopping it out. He just wanted to do anything he can to do that. So I thought that was pretty cool. Because like, you know, you think of celebrities or like big company guys, like, they don't get down and dirty. They don't like think about the small people. They just think about themselves.
Yeah, literal small India kids.
Yeah, India kids.
You know, I have a heart for those India kids. I don't know, that's cool. That's true. That's true. Yeah,
but man. It was cool hearing about
that. Happy it wasn't America kids over there.
You know those America kids.
America kids.
They get.
What did you say?
I don't know. I was
going
to say something else, but I don't
want to.
Don't say it, man.
At solutionmeals.com.
At solutionmeals.com. So what else happened to you this past 2 weeks, Brian?
I don't remember.
You don't remember?
It's been a long time. There's going to be a lot of editing.
I think all that unhealthy eating is blocking your memory.
Unhealthy eating is blocking my memory? Nah, man. I drank some beer this weekend.
Cool.
Hey. So hung out with the baby. I didn't really do much.
No, just chill.
Wait, are those things supposed to go back to back right there? I drank some beer this weekend and then hung out with the baby.
hey,
just like, watched it. I'll be sitting there.
I'm so glad you caught that.
So I'll be sitting there on the bed with my legs crossed and like a beer in my hand, drinking, like watching TV, and the baby's next to me with his legs crossed and like his sippy cup in his hand, and we're like watching fights on TV, and like it's funny because I got him into UFC, right? So. When they're fighting, he like watches intently, and then when someone does something like you're supposed to cheer for, he's like, "Oh, it's hilarious."
Just a subtle fist bump.
He's my like best friend now.
Well, that's cool, man.
He moved you out, Chris.
Oh, wow.
My best friend.
Been replaced.
Been replaced.
You've been replaced.
It's funny.
That's cool. Yeah. Nothing else?
No.
Just chilled.
Yeah. Nothing like nothing big.
It's hot. Cool. It was hot this weekend.
It was hot this weekend.
It's hot this weekend.
Yeah. That's cool.
What'd you do?
Saturday, I
let me guess, some relationship stuff.
Somewhat. I mean, not super. No, my fiance, we went and picked up her niece and nephew.
Okay.
And we took them to the park, and it was all in Fontana. So we just took him to the park, hung out with them, and you know, getting ready for the future.
How old are they?
He's like the boy's about 7.
Oh, so they're like they're 4. Kids.
Yeah.
Three or four.
Are they good kids or are they like baby kids?
They're actually pretty good.
Like, were you like ready to drop them off, or were you like, oh, I wish we could hang out more?
And they're like, oh man, no. Guys.
No, I was.
Remember,
I was,
she listens.
I was in the middle
to this.
No, I was in the middle. I was in the middle, and I feel like she was the same way because I felt like when we picked them up, they were all excited. We were at the park. They were all excited. It was going good, and towards the end, you know, they started getting tired. And cranky because of the heat.
So everyone was like ready. So you guys were like, it was cool, but we're all ready. Yeah. Like, it's cool.
He's all, you know, when I pulled him out of the trunk, she wasn't too happy with me. But I was done with them at that point.
I don't want to have kids again.
I was kitted out.
Nah. So it was cool. So I did that and then came back. We watched Lion King.
What? What did you think of The Lion King?
So it was
did you watch it?
I watched the cartoon. I haven't watched the movie.
Oh, you watched the movie?
You need to watch the movie, man.
Yeah, I watched the new movie. Honestly,
it got bad reviews, right?
I didn't look at anything before about anything reviews. I didn't hear it till after, and then but after watching it, it's just like the original, just live action. And they maybe add one like new song.
They changed one song, and then they changed a couple of the lines.
Yeah, a little bit, unless you're really a hardcore like original Lion King fan, like you know the line by line. Then you'll notice it. But honestly, you won't really.
I can just see somebody in the theater just getting super pissed. Like, no, that's not what they say in the movie.
Well, then you shouldn't have went to go watch a remake.
I'm sitting in there, no, with my Simba hat on.
That's why he hasn't gone to see. He's like, I refuse.
Exactly.
I don't watch remakes. I like the original.
No.
On a serious note, yeah, that's one of the reasons I haven't seen Aladdin. And I want to see it now.
It's good.
But you got to remember, when me and my gorgeous, beautiful, amazing girlfriend Desiree, we have four kids all together. We got a tribe. Yeah. So you got to remember, in order for us to go see a movie, we have to literally like, okay, here's the game plan. We're going in this door. If they have to go to the bathroom, I'll take two, you take two. But it's like a whole movie in itself.
You know my game plan? What? NyQuil. I enjoy the movie while they sleep.
They're just out, drugged kids.
You did good this time. No, you didn't talk. You didn't
wait, but why don't you just watch the movie or go by yourself?
So
just you two.
Oh, just me and Desiree?
Yeah.
It's a good plan. It's a good plan. But usually by the time we don't have the kids, we're ready to go to bed. Yeah. So.
I was about to say, you guys will just like...
Poop. That's the time we get rest.
Because you guys get...
Because he said he's feeling old already.
He's feeling old.
We definitely, as you guys know, I mean, you guys are both, you know, relationships. And as you know, you find the time. And it gets harder. It gets harder and harder. But no, on back to the topic. I was hesitant to watch these, what do they call them? Live action.
Live action
remakes of these movies. for that reason. The originals are just so they're Disney, good. They're great, you know, yeah. So magical. But you know, I'm kind of a believer now. I'm kind of.
Did you watch the Jungle Book when it was remade?
I did, and I liked it.
It was good.
I liked it. So you know, that's
yeah. One thing I'll say about Aladdin, because I love the original, and watching the new Aladdin, they added like two different songs and like changed the way things went a little bit. Uh-huh. So you're like, meh, but I mean, overall,
I like the changes they made on Aladdin though, like, and the changes they made in the Lion King too. I feel like they put little more details in certain spots.
Yeah.
To tell the story better.
I do agree with that.
I feel like they did, and yeah. I like the remake because it has like the big scenes that you're expecting. Yeah. And like those change a little bit because it's live action. It's not gonna be like a cartoon. You could do all sorts of crazy stuff in a cartoon, right? You can't smash stuff and expect it to live in real life. You know, like.
Well, did you cry at this part when Mufasa dies again? Or
I didn't, but there's people crying.
I got teary-eyed.
Yeah.
It was.
He's a cartoon. Crier, part
I'm a crier.
Sad.
Hey, I was.
No, the cartoon part's super sad, and then like when you see the live action, it's like it's super sad too. You're like, oh man, this is so much worse.
I feel like you feel it more just because like it just it looks just everything looks real. So it's pretty cool.
I feel like we had to say spoiler first. Spoiler alert.
Yeah.
Well, we didn't really give
Mufasa
away no
dies.
Deets.
Then again,
Mufasa
it's a remake.
Dies.
It's a remake.
Oh no, his name's Mufasa.
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 No, but even Aladdin, I got teary-eyed in that one.
Really? Oh, yeah. See, I never got teary-eyed in the
this
cartoon,
guy cries so. In a lot of movies, though.
I cry a lot.
Okay. He cried in John Wick.
You cried in... Wait.
When the puppy died, you didn't cry?
I didn't cry.
Lies.
No, I swear
I didn't see
Lies.
John Wick 3 yet.
You're like, I didn't.
Dude, John Wick 3 is dope.
I got to see it.
Dope. Yeah.
It's dope.
All right.
Like, on...
Me and Desiree
like,
literally have
you don't like action, do you?
Movies we have to,
do you like action?
Like,
do you like good acting?
I hate acting.
Wait, like you guys wrote down the list?
Yeah, we got literally a list of movies we have to watch, we have to catch up on.
Dang.
And we literally stay away from people because we want to see those movies.
You know, it's crazy.
Actually,
with
I
me,
think people stay
I
away
got
from
a list
lunch,
of movies
you know.
That I've watched, right? And it's probably the same movies that you did. But, no, but like when I want to go to the movies, it's like, okay, well, what movie am I going to watch? What haven't I seen? Well, I've seen that. I've seen that. You know, I'm just going to stay home. I've seen all those, and then the ones that I haven't seen, I'm not interested. I'm not interested in those ones.
What's one movie that you are really wanting to see right now that you have not seen?
One movie I really like, the top the one right now.
Yeah,
I'm gonna.
Yeah,
yeah. We'll
do the Five Fingers right now.
This is the one of the top five. Like,
oh, okay.
Frank questions.
I'm gonna go with Toy Story 4. I haven't seen it yet. I've heard a lot about it. I was sad when they came out with it because I thought Toy Story 3 was such a good conclusion, but. We'll see.
Okay, I'll give you my input. I won't say anything, but I cried.
Dude,
spoiler alert.
I cried.
Luda cried.
And Buzz Lightyear goes to space.
Hey, what movie did we watch right before it started? What movie did we watch before it started? I was like, you better not cry.
I don't know what movie it was.
And you're like, I might cry. I'm like, you better not cry in this movie.
Godzilla.
Well, I might.
Was it because we watched... Watch Transformers together.
Yeah.
In Jurassic Park. Was it Jurassic Park? I don't know.
I don't think it was. It's probably Transformers. Because Transformers has some serious moments.
Nah, I didn't cry.
Was it the B movie, right?
The Bumblebee?
Bumblebee?
Yeah.
That's a good
I think
one.
I got
That's
heartfelt. I didn't cry, though.
Got heartfelt.
But you wanted to.
No.
I think I leaned over to you. You want to cry? No. Okay. I don't cry.
Is that all right?
All right. So since we asked one Frank five questions.
Questions.
I had like a little.
At solutionmeals.com.
Thanks. Brian, you want to ask?
I got another movie Frank? One. You're familiar with the Rocky movies, right?
Yeah.
What's your favorite one?
Rocky 3.
What? Rocky That's 3. Right, man. That's my Rocky favorite 3. One.
Come on, man.
What's
Come
your
on.
Favorite?
I would say Rocky 2.
Why? Because you don't know good movies?
Or? Wow.
No, I was kidding. We're like Rocky 3 fans over here.
So you're saying all the Rocky movies are not good?
No, I was just kidding, man. Okay. I like all of them.
They're great. Right. They're all great.
They're all great. But like, I like 3 because it's the action. I feel like there's more like action in that. And then he comes from so much, like, he goes through so much in that movie.
Yeah, dude.
I feel like.
I feel like out of all the Rockies, that's the Rockies. I feel like out of all the Rocky movies, that's the realest one.
That's the one that put the eye of the tiger in me.
Exactly.
All right. The third Frank Five question. If you were...
What did you just say? Frank Five question. Oh, Frank Five question. Yeah, oh, okay. Frank.
Pay attention, Danny, or we're not going to have you on here again.
I thought you were trying to say French fries, and I was French like, fries. I want French fries.
Okay, so.
You're not acting like a good guest, man.
If you were in a room or, like, say a theater.
Like we are now.
Or sitting on a stage with lights around
you're
us.
You're on a stage, lights on you.
Air conditioning humming in the background.
What's one thing, like, okay, since you're an artist, I'm going to go there.
Okay.
So since you're an artist, you're a good salesman. So.
A good BSer.
That's basically.
What's one piece of advice you would give to those people?
Who's they? Who's those people?
People who are like musicians or salesmen.
Oh.
We'll go with that.
That's a weird question. You went so...
Like, that's like a Doctor Strange kind of like multiverse.
You're like, first
question.
You're in a room. No, yeah, wait, right. You're in a theater.
Okay. I just said
there's a fly buzzing around.
Clear the question out. Just clear it up.
It could be a room, a theater. It doesn't matter. Just
a room full of people.
A room full of people that are coming to like hear what you say.
Okay.
And it could be about music and sales, just because...
That's what you do.
That's what you do.
Yeah.
Okay. So, and if you just want to choose one of those two, that's fine. But, yeah.
But if you had to tell them one thing, what's the one thing you would tell them?
So if I gave them one line of advice.
Yeah, one line of advice.
Y'all quit.
Room full of people. I know, right? Turn around.
Don't try.
Don't go on the Big Tasty podcast. I think if I had a room full of people in front of me, I'd tell them, if you don't eat at solutionmeals.com. One line of advice, you know what? At this point in my life, I would look right at them and say, it's okay to be insecure. There's nothing wrong with insecurity. Everybody has this major thing that you have to be, in order to be on that stage, that guy has to be perfect.
Yeah.
No, I'm probably worse off than all of them, but that's okay. That's okay. As long as we're able to be transparent with people, that seeing what I know now about life, being transparent with people is possibly one of the most valuable things ever. I mean, we've all been a-holes. We've all been liars, you know, but to be able to be completely transparent and show people your insecurities is like, that's huge. That's huge.
No, it is.
That's cool.
I just threw wisdom at you.
That's pretty dope.
Pterodactyls fly in circles.
There you go.
What?
That's what he really would have said.
I would have said,
pterodactyls fly in circles.
You don't drink blonde lattes. You can't hang with me.
All right, what do you do with
your life?
What's your go-to drink at Starbucks right now?
My go-to drink right now, okay, you ready for this?
Yeah.
Venti iced blonde latte with soy, an ad shot, and 2 packs of raw sugar.
That sounds like something my girl drinks.
Hey, then she must have great taste.
Just saying.
She must have great taste, iced coffee.
Just saying. I drink my coffee black, bro.
He doesn't drink coffee.
Iced coffee said could
you.
Be black.
You do?
Yeah, man.
I've never seen one cup of coffee in your hand before.
Dude, I drink coffee all the time.
In secret, in the bathroom.
Is it the bathroom?
Last week.
While I watch videos of the India kids being saved and crying.
I literally drank 32 cups of coffee every day last week.
Dang.
I love coffee, man.
You guys didn't see it, but Chris keeps looking at his phone trying to see how long we're actually taking.
I know. How many questions?
This is going to be a 2-hour special. You probably are going to have to split up this interview. Which I think it's still an interview.
No, yeah, I think it's still.
I think you're just a guest now.
I know, right? I got a residency with the Big Tasty.
Residency.
Yeah. At the end of the year, we're gonna have the listeners vote for their favorite.
I know, right?
Favorite guest.
I'm gonna be the last one on the list.
There's only 2 guests of the year.
What's a hate mail? Never have that guy on again. Pterodactyls don't fly in circles.
I honestly don't have the last question.
The last question.
Yeah. I didn't come prepared.
He didn't drink coffee today.
Why do you comb your hair like that?
How do I? Okay.
That's
my fifth question, okay, man.
First, somebody has to describe my hair. Mind you, Brian's wearing a hat.
Yeah.
And Luda is, boy.
Well, I have like a buzz
Luda
cut right now.
Luda has hair. He has that silver fox look that I hate.
I have a buzz cut right now.
You have a buzz cut?
Yeah. So like I switch it up all the time. Yeah, it's hot, so I got a buzz cut. Right? He has like a comb over type haircut.
Comb over, going bald cut.
Yeah. Why do you comb your hair like that?
I'm going bald. No, it's just.
I just wanted to point it out.
Luda.
I mean,
how long have I had my hair like this now? Years, huh?
Yeah, as long as I can remember.
I guess
since you were 5.
I think in high school you used to do like you would comb it front and then like put it up like that. Like right
I had that one.
The douche bro look. Yeah. The douche bro look.
I had that.
No, at first I think it was spiky hair.
Yeah.
and then you did the front.
You ever
couple times?
No. I'm gonna tell you a story. Okay, I had one time I dyed the first time I dyed my hair.
Oh yeah, I remember that.
She dyed it all maroon, which I asked for.
Yeah,
and I had bleach tips. So many people you look like gave me so much crap for
like
that
haircut. Like a fireball?
I did. I looked like a fireball. I looked like the Flash, but I loved it. I really did. I loved it. Oh, I liked it because it was different. It didn't look like what everybody else had.
You got pictures? You got pictures of that?
I might. I'll find
it. I want to laugh.
I do have a picture of me.
I want to laugh.
With a faux hawk, and I literally look like Bill Nye the Science Guy.
Hey, I went on electrocuted. I went on my 8th grade graduation, right? And I had like hair that you spiked all over. You remember that? It was cool. You spike everything all
yeah,
over.
Everything. Yeah, everything. Yeah, that's right? What you used to do.
Right? So that's basic, right?
I used to
so
do that
I had that, right? We went to Farrell's Last Kingdom. It was like a water park where they have like bumper cars and stuff like that, right? And then like we went down the water slide, and then like my gel went out of my hair. So I walked around the rest of the day like with the afro, right? Everybody was making fun of me the whole day. It was the worst eighth grade field trip ever. I was like, man,
he just brings up
dumb.
The pain of the past.
It was worse.
Talk about hair.
I kissed my first girl on the eighth grade field trip, like real kiss, like made out. On the bus, though, with that afro.
No.
With that one.
Back then, it
with
was called afro. Macking.
Oh, yeah.
Or scamming. Remember scamming?
Oh, man. Yeah.
Oh, they scammed.
I didn't hear
that. You know what? And it wasn't even my girlfriend that I made out with.
Oh.
What?
Confessions.
Well, because it was like one of those things, like, I broke up with you this morning. It's my new girlfriend this afternoon.
Okay.
Right?
Spike girlfriend.
Spike girlfriend.
Rebound.
Yeah.
That was your first rebound.
Yeah. How long did that second girlfriend last?
To the end of the bus ride.
To the end of the bus ride.
So I'm a player. The first one ended because she wouldn't kiss me. The second one ended because she kissed too much. I was like, Susia.
Back
off. No, I was kidding. But
buddy. Dang, that's crazy. I remember one time I was
shout out to Sarah.
I was in eighth grade and went to it was a water park. Well, not a water park. It was Independence Park. And everyone's, you know, jumping off the diving board, but like the smaller one, and there's the big one, and one guy did it, and everyone's like, oh dang, he's, you know, like, oh, he's cool, and so I was like, I could do that. It's not that hard. You just jump and look down and go into the water. So
hope you're over the water.
What happened, Chris?
So I climb up there, I get up there, and I, you know, all right, let's do this. And you know, you're up there, you're like, damn, this is higher than I thought. And then I'm like, yeah, I'm already up here. I can't chicken out now. So I jumped, and I'm in midair, and I'm thinking, I'm like, yeah, I got this. I'm going down. I'm like, oh, cool. And then I hit the water.
Belly flopped.
I belly flopped.
Oh, hard, were you chunky back then?
No, I wasn't that chunky.
No? So it was like all ribs? That must have hurt.
It wasn't all ribs.
Oh! Got bruised ribs.
But I get up, and everyone's like, hey, you all right, Chris? Like you
did you try
okay?
to play it off? Did
and
you try to play
like,
it off?
Yeah, I'm all right. I'm cool.
He's crying.
Did you guys give me? I would have been like, I would have been like,
the inside.
10? Did I get a 10? 9.5? Yeah, right? I did that on purpose.
Everybody's holding up numbers.
Yeah.
But what was cool was like this. At that time, this girl that I liked, we barely talked, but she was like, she came up to me and she was like, hey, you okay? And I was like, yeah, I'm all right. You know, trying to be all hard.
Plan was a success.
Yeah. But nothing happened.
Nothing happened.
Dang.
Yeah, no. Sounds like your life. Yeah. No, kidding, belly flopping, nothing happened. No, I was kidding. Dang. That was mean.
Calm down, fro.
I'm sorry. Yeah. Don't mess with my fro, bro.
I got cue ball.
They made out with me like that, so... That's how they lacked it to me.
She felt bad.
Hey, real quick, I wanted to mention some of our feedback that we got from our our last, our first.
You guys already got our feedback?
Only. Yeah, man, because we got some listeners, man. And one was, I talk too much. I talk over Chris. Like, I tend not to let him talk. Mm. So I'm working on that.
Yeah, you did pretty good today.
I think so. Well, Danny talks a lot, so.
I talk a lot. I do.
Then another one was that we don't know nothing about basketball.
Yeah, I heard
our friend,
that too.
Our friend Gordo said nothing. You know nothing about basketball.
Wow, that's like a direct critique right there.
Yeah, and I was like, we never claimed.
Wait, let's ask Danny.
What's up?
The question that we asked, or that we stated.
Yeah, Francisco, Pancho, Gordo, whatever you want to be called. listen.
This one's for you.
So we said that you can't win a championship without a big three.
Okay.
Okay. That the most all the champions that won. They had big three, you know, Shaq and Kobe and who
Gasol.
There you go. Know nothing about basketball.
I drew a blank on his name. Gasol. You said it was you had Jordan's, Pippen, and
Rodman.
Rodman.
Yeah.
And the Celtics. You had a big three. Miami Heat, you had a big three.
Magic yeah. Johnson didn't win without Kareem and I forget who else it was. but you know, you get where we're going. Like yeah. when it was just two big stars, they really it's hard to win because
yeah. flop. Yeah.
Yeah. yeah.
So right? I mean, obviously you need a whole team.
Yeah.
But you need that big three. So do you agree or disagree?
Oh, that's this. Okay. What's his name? Francesco?
Francesco?
Yeah.
Francesco.
Francesco?
Listen, friends, Italy, wait, okay?
His argument was, look at Kawhi Leonard did with this team that didn't have no big three.
Okay, look where he's at now. Look where he's at now.
Exactly.
He's jumping ship.
Right?
Okay.
But he the one team that did it, and it just happened to be the last team that did it.
Exactly. So this is a science thing, Franzarelli, okay? This is literally sports science, okay? To have a big three means you have a star, a support, and a powerhouse. You have to have all three of those things to be successful in basketball. Otherwise, you could have you could have a star player and they could run up and down the court, but look at LeBron.
Yeah.
He came to the Lakers and everybody thought, oh, this is it. This is our year. This is going to happen. He gets hurt.
Yeah.
Hurt. I'm doing quotation marks. He gets hurt and all of a sudden he can't play and now his team has to carry his fame. Not necessarily has to carry his talent or the fact that he got injured, they have to carry that reputation. And let's be honest, most people buckle under that.
Yeah.
Most players will buckle under that. So you have to have a solid three. If you really want to get into the science of it, there's always a fourth.
Yeah.
There's always we would call a third man, but there's always a fourth player that is also a support, and it's always a rook that comes out of nowhere and takes up that
Kuzma.
I'll say Kuzma.
Exactly. So
he's not a rookie, he's coming up.
Frangitelli.
Yeah. So we also didn't claim to know everything. Yeah. We're just giving our opinions.
Yeah.
My opinion, you need a big three.
Well, I mean, if you know every stat about basketball, you need a girlfriend.
He's gonna be like, I really don't have, guys.
I really don't have time to sit there and like look up like, oh, this is how many dunks he had. Oh, this is how many shots he had in the key. You know, I don't have time to look up all that.
Yeah,
but I can watch a game and tell you at the end of that game who's talented, who's not talented.
Agreed.
Yep.
Agreed. There you go. Yeah. Well.
So yeah, and we will have Poncho on the show.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, Poncho I call him Poncho now. First, I called him Gordo. Later, I'm gonna call him Francisco. Now we're gonna have him on the show so he could defend himself.
All right,
okay,
right?
Ponzarelli.
But I don't like him. But we'll have him on the show. We won't offer him no water. We won't offer him no water.
You guys didn't even offer me water.
Yeah, Starbucks, man.
Oh, that's true.
Dude, I don't even have water.
I know. Thanks for offering me something.
I don't even think we have water.
Yeah,
this sucks. We're coming on this show again.
It's a low budget podcast.
I'm never coming on this show again. It's my show.
Oh man! Any other feedback?
Feedback. That it was good. They liked our flow, and that we were nervous at first in the first one, but once we started talking about topics and we got more comfortable, that we really sounded good. So.
Yeah. Nice. I mean, I think that's the thing. It's just for us. Like our whole thing is for this podcast is just to. For one, give our opinions and just talk about different things that we want to talk about that, you know, are important to us or meaningful to us or whatever it may be.
Yeah. So. And then one was someone listened to the podcast. He was like, you know, don't do it because you want to be famous or don't do it because you're trying to look for stuff. He's like, do it just because you're having fun. And if you don't have no listeners, who cares?
Yeah.
Right?
It's like, all right. You want to connect with people.
Yep. That's all we want to do.
Yeah.
Dude, that's impressive that you already have feedback from your first show. I mean, that's your first podcast. I mean, Your first stream.
And then two of them were like, hey, when's the next one?
Yeah.
Nice. When's the next one? That's why we decided to go to every week. Yeah. We decided to go weekly instead of every other week because people were asking.
Yeah. So we're going to do
it. I was only two, but still.
But see, I think that just shows you that we value people who listen to it.
Yeah.
I mean, even though we're barely starting.
Only our two listeners asked.
But imagine how what we're going to be like after 50 episodes.
Yeah, you're going to have to have somebody screen it. You're going to have to have somebody screen all the comments and be like, this guy's just talking about Pop-Tarts, so don't answer him.
Yeah,
we're going to have to get a producer. What?
We'll find one.
What? You're like, I thought I was a producer. What? What?
I know. How rude.
I know.
Just got demoted.
Whatever.
Well, all right. Well, I think that's it because I think we're trying to keep it within the time limit.
Yeah.
So, thanks, Danny, for joining us for the podcast.
Yeah. Well, let me do my shameless plug, too. Pug.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, plug. How do people follow you?
So
where do people find you?
In reality, I do have music. Danny Medina Music.
We didn't even
talk
about
it. You can follow it on Instagram. Nah, you don't even talk about my music.
Yeah, it's not good.
I'm actually, just to throw it in there, right? No, just to plug myself, I'm currently working with an old buddy of mine. His name's Grayson Grimes. Great. You guys got to listen to him too.
Yeah, he's dope. We're
currently working on getting me an EP. So, you know, hopefully I'll be making some moves here and actually put out an album.
I know. What? Real quick, how long?
You could have talked about that during the podcast, man. When we asked you to talk about yourself.
It was funner to talk about other things. Like, you being having a fro and Chris belly flopping for no reason whatsoever.
Real quick, so everyone knows, how long have you been singing and playing?
I picked up guitar when I was 14 and started singing when I was 16.
So 2 years ago.
I wish.
No, we said... So at his actual age, not the age he acts.
100 years ago.
Not the age he acts.
But yeah, so I've been playing for a while. But yeah, follow my music.
What type of music? What type
another
of music
thing,
is it?
You know, me and my girlfriend Desiree, we just want to plug. You know, if you see a homeless person out in the street, don't just walk by him. Offer him some food. Yeah, learn his name or her name, you know, the people. So right now we have a pretty big heart for reaching out to the homeless community because it's a major issue right now.
Yeah, especially out here in Orange County.
Right now. I know, for real.
And if I'm elected, no, it's just a major issue right now.
I won't
now,
vote for him.
You know, I really think that if we all got together and took care of one homeless person a day or even just cared about one, we wouldn't have an issue with homeless people.
Maybe we could have another podcast where we could talk about all that.
Maybe we could have a homeless person on.
I was about to say, I was like, maybe we could just get a homeless person.
Where's Aaron?
Where's Aaron? Dang! I hope you're listening, Aaron.
I don't even know who Aaron is, but hey, dang.
I hope you're listening, Aaron, because you like him more than you like me, I didn't say that.
Nah.
So,
Aaron, you just got roasted. I don't even know who you are, but you got roasted.
I
love
Aaron. Hey, I posted something on Facebook the other day. Like, I don't know. Like, I wonder how many people see my friend request or see me in, like, the suggested friends, and they're like, oh, fuck that asshole. Right? And then Aaron commented on it, and he was like, I thought that for reals. And I was like, yeah, I know, because you invite everybody to all sorts of stuff, and you're like, leave out Brian. I am kind of mean to him, though. Well, obviously, Chris is, too.
It's probably because you like him.
Nah.
I mean, he's a special character.
Oh,
he's
cool. Okay.
But I mean to Chris,
have
though.
I met Aaron?
Yeah, I'll tell you about him.
Oh, okay.
I mean to him, though, too. Some people shy away from it.
You're mean to you.
Yeah.
Let's talk about the real issue.
Yeah, sorry.
How do you feel about you, Brian?
I hate myself. No. No, I just like making people feel like shit. I like making people feel like shit.
Right? I like to bring others down and make myself feel better.
I think, like I said, we could talk about that on future podcasts.
Yeah,
yeah. Because then, to come.
Because I think that what you're going through or why you do that, we can figure out that.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm not saying to stop. I mean, that makes who you are.
I think it's funny.
Yeah.
No, I was kidding.
Other people laugh.
There's
right?
deeper feelings. Yeah. Other people laugh.
Yeah.
So at work, when I walk into the office, everyone turns and waits for me to make fun of him. Like, and then I feel like, dang, I gotta say something.
And what's funny is you actually have to go out of your way to say something to me because, like, I'm in a, like, against the wall behind my supervisor.
And like I see everybody. As soon as I walk in, they're like craning their necks. They're like,
wow.
And they're like, man, now I gotta say something. I really was gonna come for like some out. Business stuff.
Good thing you watched all those DVDs.
Right? Yeah, good thing I watched all those DVDs. Burn!
Stole that joke.
Whatever. So, all right, well,
I don't like either.
I mean,
you
if you want, you know, you could join us in the next podcast.
And, yeah, well, thanks, guys. I had a good time.
Interview you again.
Best of luck. Ryan, there's another guy in here. Ryan just checked out my pants right now. I don't know if he was looking at my pants or my
I was looking at your package.
We're all wearing black pants.
Oh, yeah, we are.
Mine's a little faded, though.
Pray for the India kids.
They got stuck in a hole 5 years ago. 5 years ago. Talk about Curry. I think that's what
we're talking about. LMS. Elon Musk.
LMS.
LMS. LMS. LMSOP. All right, I think that's where we end it.
Yeah.
Make you fun of Curry.
Hashtag New York.
Bye.
All right, guys. Until next week. Peace out.
Later.